to be hurting one another, but now they're going to decide who of the big boys is going to be the first one to make a move. And I suggest that the move that will be made will be an awful long way out. As Dominic Karui leads, and Paul Koech coming up on the outside, having slight little arguments with one another, but there's only because the race has not really started in earnest yet, as they come down the home straight with 11 laps to go.
Karui leads, Koech second, Gabriel Selassie is third, Hissou four, and Jifar of Ethiopia. Certainly you'd expect pace to be injected at some stage now in the second half of the race. Hissou in fourth place. When he broke the world record last year, he ran 13:12 for the second 5,000 metres. That's unbelievable. But Gabriel Selassie then knocked seconds off it this year. Karui now being tested by Gabriel Selassie. Jifar's there. On the inside is Koech, and Hissou, and Castro of Portugal. The other Kenyan, Paul Turgat, second in the Olympic Games last year when they gave Gebre Selassie such a workout, he wasn't able to run again for weeks, mainly because of the hard track, but the Kenyans gave him a hard time, and that bunching caused him problems. 10 to go, and Hissou takes it on now, and this really is an injection of pace, if it's sustained.
Well, 10 laps to go, I feel that in a distance rate like this, 10 laps to go is not too far out. And quite honestly, if Salah Hissou, who's now leading, wants this title, then he's going to have to do some damage to the great Gebre Selassie, who's in third place there. He can't do it in the last lap, he's shown that in the past. Can he do it from 10 laps out? Well, it's a brave effort to try that. It is a long way to go, and there are some world-class athletes behind him. But the issue for Salah Hissou now is if he wants a medal badly enough, he's going to have to do it on his own here. He's going to have to keep consistent. He's going to have to keep his form up, and he's going to have to keep pushing and working. He's going to have to ignore what's happening behind him. And really, he's going to have to start injecting laps closer to 60 seconds than they've been so far. They've been at 70 seconds.
There's a gap up now. There's 8 or 9 athletes in the leading group. This time the lap marker showing 9 left. Paul Koech, the leader. Gabriel Selassie second. Paul Turgat in third place. Fourth is Hissou. And they keep chopping and changing position. And Jifar now goes into fourth place. In sixth place is Castro. Seventh is Mezigibu. Eighth is Ray of Spain. But they're being stretched out. Interesting to see what the next lap time is.
Well, that last lap time, David, was the fastest lap of the race so far. Most of the laps have been close to 67, 68 seconds, and that one was 63.8. So now the race is starting in earnest, and the group has now got down already after just that one hard lap. There are 7 in that leading group, and they're pulling away from Ray, the Spaniard. So the only European in this leading group of Africans is the Portuguese Domingos Castro, the fastest marathon runner in the world this year, but he's being tested now, and this lap I would imagine will be almost as fast as the last lap, and that's when the damage starts to be done. 8 laps to go, and that lap was a 63 second lap again, the fastest lap of the race this so far, 63.43.
and then drop one of the Kenyans, that's Karui. So the Kenyans down to 2 in the leading group. The Moroccans only have 1. The Ethiopians have 2. And Koech pushing hard in front. Gabriel Selassie now tracking him. Turgat in third place. Hissou 4. Castro 5. Jifar 6. Turgat so long and rangy. Won the world cross country this time for the 3rd time. Two Ethiopians at the back of that group, Jifar and Mezigibu, who's only 19, got a tremendous record. World junior champion last year at 5,000 and 10,000 metres. Here he is in the world championship senior final. Koenig leads, Gebrselassie second, Turgot third, Hissou fourth. Tracking back, Castro's five. And Giffard.
Well, I've just worked it out there. They've just run the last mile in about 4 minutes and 12 seconds. When you think about that, they ran the first mile in 4:35. So now the middle of the race and the pressure really beginning to apply. 63 seconds, 64 second laps. And it'll wear them down. The first one to drop off the back of the group is the Giffard, the Ethiopian. And now, still Domingos Castro in that group. And there's five Africans, Domingos Castro, and the champion, the reigning champion, the Olympic champion, the world record holder in second place. They're not even extending him yet, because this pace is no faster than he ran when he set the world record. It's not a world record run tonight. It's going to be a fast second half of the race, but there we're looking in second place to the great Haile Gebrselassie.
Well, there's a lot of support for the Ethiopians. They've now only got two in that leading group. Gebrselassie. And Mezi Gebu. Who's at the back of that group of six. Koenig leads, he's really cutting it out. Perhaps inspired by the win of his knees last night. Sally Barsosio, the Kenyan who became the first Kenyan woman to win a world title. There's Domingos Castro of Portugal, the fastest marathon runner in the world this year when he won the Rotterdam. He's really running well in this, no question about it. And the World Championship 5000 in 87, he was second, fifth in the same event in 91. And he's gradually stepped up in distance, but come out and live with these Africans. The Europeans don't often do that.
Well, I agree with that, David. It's great to see one of the Europeans. It's particularly good to see one of the Portuguese, because they're good, honest runners. He's been around for a long time, Domingos Castro. It's great to see him outrun a good marathon, but he's been good at 5,000 metres, 10,000 metres, the marathon and the cross-country races, and it's great to see him actually take on these Africans. Most of the European athletes are overawed by the Africans, to such an extent that John Brown, the British athlete who's run the second fastest time ever by a British athlete over 10,000 metres, decided he didn't want to take part in this race and hasn't even arrived here. But now we're approaching four laps to go, and this is the time that somebody is going to have to make a move if they've got any ambition of trying to wrest the title from Haile Gebrselassie. I wonder if anyone will.
Actually, Koenig is doing it from the front. He spurted then as he passed the four lap marker. But Gebrselassie looks dangerous in second place. He's so easy. Hissou in third place. No doubt focusing on Gebrselassie's back and thinking, well, you've taken my world title away, I'm going to take your world championship away.
That's right. And in this group, there are only six men who've ever run under 27 minutes for 10,000 metres, and four of them are in this group. Gebrselassie, the world record holder, then Salah Hissou, and Paul Turgot, and Paul Koenig. They're the four men who've run under 26 minutes. They're all in, four of the six men have run under 27 minutes. They're all here, and they're all being strung along by the leader, Paul Koenig. I don't think he's doing too much damage to Gebrselassie so far, and they're getting involved now with lap runners. Sometimes that can be a little bit of a danger, and they've got three laps to go, and Paul Koenig now just stretching them along. That was a 63 second lap, but he's going to have to pick up some momentum, and I'm surprised that Paul Turgot hasn't been able to take them on. I'm surprised that Hissou hasn't done anything, and it looks to me as though they're playing this race to the tune of Haile Gebrselassie.
Koenig has worked so hard in front. He's done all the graft. Gebrselassie's second. Hissou moves up to his shoulder just to let him know he's there. Castro is four, Turgot is five, Mezi Gebu in sixth place. Two Kenyans, two Ethiopians, one Moroccan and one Portuguese. It's been a fine run by Koenig, really gutsy.
Thank you.
But he's in the worst place, Coetzee. He's in the lead and they're queuing up behind him. The two former world record holders are side by side, Gebrselassie and Salah Hissou. Paul Turgot surprisingly hasn't made a move yet as they now come down with two laps to go in the men's 10,000 metres.
Someone surely will make an early move. Will they all wait for the last 400? It's doubtful. Gebrselassie moves dangerously to the leader's shoulder. What he's doing is running a slightly wide there to block anyone coming from the back. Somebody's got to go a long way round. Hissou follows. Turgot made no move at all, but Castro's right with these with a lap and a half left. The other man is Mezigibu in sixth place, only 19.
And there goes Gebrselassie. Well, he didn't need to go that early, but look at that acceleration. He's blown them away in the course of 50 metres, and now the reigning champion is on his way.
He can see one to go. Hear the music of the bell. Turgot's gone second, Hissou third, but Gebrselassie too good. The break was decisive. Even when he took the first 10 strides, they weren't prepared to go with him. They couldn't go with him anyway. He's full of running. Absolutely flying away from them. And even though they're chasing hard, they're not catching him. Turgot is in second place and Hissou third. Fourth is the longtime leader, Coetzee. 200 left. This, a majestic last lap. Really, for the Ethiopian, a lap of honour. He's won this so nicely. Turgot is closing, but he'll never catch him. So, Gebrselassie wins for the third time in succession the World Championship at 10,000 metres. Turgot is second, Hissou is third, Coetzee is fourth, Mezigibu five, and Castro in sixth place, 33, the Portuguese, a really gallant try.
Well, that's amazing. However the race was going to be run, Gebrselassie, the world record holder, the reigning champion, was certainly going to be the one to beat. And I think if they'd run faster, he would have won it. If they'd run slower, he would have won it. But the key to the race for Gebrselassie was actually when he made the burst.